What is going on? Today is a big day. Today, the update to the ASRX manual is live. Update 1.1 is live for those of you enrolled in the ASRX Beginner's Manual. Today is a great date for you. The update contains a massive amount of in-depth stuff covering the ASRX. And of course, with all updates, we just keep on going more and more into the sampler at hand. At this point, it is the ASRX. Also, very special, there's an incredible Easter egg that I've put in there, something that will unlock. Trust me, email me, let me know what you think of that Easter egg, but it's going to help you and answer a lot of questions and solve a lot of problems with the ASRX. Update 1.1, once again, live right now for those of you who are thinking about getting an ASRX, on the fence about it, want to know more, want to understand this quirky Frankenstein amazing box, this manual is for you. Anyway, what I wanted to drop a little video about today is the low end of the ASRX. I was doing some experimenting on NTSC PAL where the full length of this video is, but I want to just do a synopsis here to just really get to the point of what this sampler does to your samples and why I consider it one of the best sounding samplers in existence right now. What I was doing was some experimenting, and I started out with just a regular drum beat. Here it is. Now, if you are a boom bap head, you ought to know what that rhythm is. If you don't, you ought to find out and study that track, study the lyrics in that track. If you're an MC and call yourself any type of a boom bap head, that rhythm should be very meaningful to you. Anyhow, I started with that and I resampled it. And what I wanted to do was to sort of end up grunging up the sample. So I went from this, sped it up, then slowed it down. Then we dirtied it up a little bit. Dirtied it up a little bit more. And then what I ended up doing was speeding it up again and then slowed it down. And then slowed it down a little bit more. And I continued to do that until I found the kick. Right? And then I slowed that down and ended up with this. Just listen to how it retains the bottom end. Fattens up the bottom end. And keeps everything rumbly and warm and massive. So I did all of that to experiment to end up with that. But this type of low end is where this shines. Also in the high end, it sparkles up your samples. It keeps just a nice fat bottom on your samples. By the way, this is the original. I had three versions of it. That's the original. That's 12-bit. That's 8-bit. Original, 12-bit, 8-bit. You can hear a little bit of fuzz on the 8-bit. Original, a little bit tighter. 12-bit, middle of the road. 8-bit. By the way, speaking about bits, episode 106 of the Samplers podcast is out right now, talking about nothing else than bit depth and samplers. After you're finished watching that, check it out, as well as the ASRX manual update. If you are enrolled, check your email. Just check in with your manual. You'll see a whole bunch of new goodies there for you. Anyways, quick video. That's all I wanted to share. Just wanted to share my ongoings. Of course, the longer version and the more exploratory version is on NTSC PAL. For those of you who don't know what NTSC PAL is, it's the new subscription service at thedaydreamsound.com where all the in-depth sampler stuff is. Anyhow, I will catch you on the next one. In the meantime, please do take care of yourself. Peace.